In this video, we're going to talk about pure substances and mixtures. So, matter can, in general, be broken down into either a pure substance or a mixture, depending upon its composition. Pure substance can be either what we call an element or a compound, and I'll explain what those are in just a moment if you don't know. A pure substance is just one thing in there. It's an element or a compound. A mixture has two or more things, two or more elements or compounds in it. And that mixture can be what we call homogeneous or it can be heterogeneous. And we'll distinguish those in just a moment. So let's look at elements versus compounds. An element is something that cannot be broken down any further at all by chemical means and still have the same properties. The periodic table, which you've probably seen before, lists all of the known elements in the universe. Now, a molecule can be either an element or a compound, but what a molecule is two or more atoms that are bonded together. If those two atoms are the same as each other, the same element, then that's still an element, that molecule. But if there's two or more different elements that are bonded together to make a molecule, that's a compound. So what makes something a compound is that it has two or more elements, different elements combined in it. So for example, C, if you look on the periodic table, you'll see C. It's the symbol for the element carbon. And if you have carbon, you can't break that down any further and still have it be carbon. It's an element. Hydrogen, okay, the symbol for the element hydrogen is H2. The two here just means there are two atoms of the element hydrogen attached to each other, and that ends up being the form that hydrogen takes. It's still an element because there's just one kind of atom in there. Now, water has a symbol H2O. The symbol O stands for oxygen, and there's two hydrogens. It's just coincidence that there's a two here and a two here. There's compounds where there's more different numbers of hydrogens. But this is a compound because what makes it a compound is there are two or more elements, oxygen and hydrogen in this case. Now, a mixture has two or more substances that are combined physically but not chemically. So they don't combine to make a compound or something. They're separate compounds or elements. For example, air. Air is a mixture, and the main components of air are nitrogen, the element nitrogen, and the element oxygen. So that's the N2s are nitrogen, excuse me, the O2s are oxygens. And they're mixed together, but they're not combined. You see the oxygens and the nitrogens aren't combining with each other. They're still separate from each other. That's a mixture. We'll see that this is what we call a homogeneous mixture. Now, homogeneous just means that when you look at that mixture, you cannot see the different components with your unaided eye. Now, if you have a good enough instrument, sure, you can always see them, right? But it's your unaided eye that's the distinguishing factor. In a heterogeneous mixture, you can see the different components with your unaided eye. So what do you think? Is black coffee, it's a mixture, I'll just tell you that. It has water and a bunch of different molecules in it to give it its color and flavor and all that good stuff. Is it homogeneous or heterogeneous? It's homogeneous because you can't distinguish different parts. You can't tell, oh, there's a molecule of caffeine. You can't see it. Now, what about an oatmeal raisin cookie? Heterogeneous or homogeneous? Sure, it's heterogeneous because you can see the raisins, you can see the cookie and the different parts of that with your unaided eye. That's the distinguishing factor. Now, brass. Brass is a mixture. It ends up with copper and zinc, maybe a couple of other things. Do you think it's heterogeneous or homogeneous? Well, sure, it's homogeneous because with your unaided eye, you cannot see the different parts of it.